Tunes here. Again, they have nothing whatever to do with the sea, but what the heck, eh? Well, I'm having a nice time, so we'll play this tune. Ben learnt this. It's a tune, I heard it first ages ago. My mum bought me a CD of Steel House Band. I used to like Steel House Band when I was a young person. And she bought this CD, not CD, it was a cassette tape, when Ben was about 7 or 8. And he heard this, and I think that's what so heavily influenced him in the violin, because the fiddle player from Steel House Band, a chap called Peter Knight, who, fantastic player, and he played this tune, it's called Tam Lin. We used to play it as a part of an Irish group, but this is the version that was on the original recording. It's a brilliant reel. It's not fast, but it's fantastic. And it goes into another splendid reel called Woman or Women of the House. And it's not sea-related whatsoever, but it doesn't matter, because you used to get violins on boats. You used to sit on the capstan and sing and play and whatever. I was going to play that in the wrong key, that would have been good.
Hang on, sorry, I've got an itch.
And it goes with me carries, goes around in this little tin. It's got other interesting things in here. It's got a little spoon. Look at that. That's to take the pegs out if I get a busted string.
That's another story.
So this is a song inspired. How many people here have read The Riddle of the Sands? Please, somebody. Oh, good. Yeah, The Riddle of the Sands. This is a song inspired thoroughly by that fantastic book, which I've read umpteen times. And I don't want to mention this again, but if you do buy the CD, Martin's a brilliant marine artist, and he did an exhibition of paintings inspired, as my song was, but inspired by the story of The Riddle of the Sands. He went to the Frisian Islands and he brought me back that shell. He did the song book, the pictures in there, the poster, the lovely drawings on the posters, Martin's work. He's there blushing and hiding in the shadows. And in that book of the songs is a lovely painting of his of a Thames sailing barge, and then one inside the back cover of a couple of chaps leaning on the rail, pounding into a lovely sea. Anyway. Utterly lost. Oh yes, in the booklet there's a centrefold, is a reproduction of a painting of Roseabella, which is about lying on the sands. But anyway, this is the song, The Riddle of the Sands. And I'm guaranteed that no one's ever written a song with the words, possibly not galvanised or ribbon gill in it. But yeah, they're in there. There you look for them.
He looked to the eastwards, saw gentle breezes from the northwest with a gale at their stern. They'd track the Medusa to the boiling shores that roared on the banks of the trap that Owen heard. Companion Carruthers, spares rigging screws galvanized, number three ripping gill, pictures of bite of a deep stirring tale of intrigue and treachery on wide lonely sandbanks swept by the tide. Companion Roseabella's her name, famous her skipper, safe is that yacht in that seafarer's hands. Together they'll wander through channels and islands, together they'll fathom out the riddle of the sands. Creeping blind through the fog banks and tortuous tideways, till the dinghy's keel scrapes on Bennett's low shores, to the heart of the mystery bound up with destiny, plans to fight England, invasion and war. Does the bell